So we have Mr. Meenakshi Sundaram. He comes from a village called Suttamalli village in Tirunelveli district, a person from a very, very humble background, did his schooling in Palayankottai, which is a small town in Tamil Nadu. And then he went on to do his MSc and MPhil in zoology. And after a lot of perseverance, he got into the IAS in the 2004 batch. And he also has hobbies of reading books and philately and many other interests. So a very distinguished officer from the Northeastern cadre. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you. Thank you, Rangarajan. In fact, it's a proud privilege and honor to be present and to be able to interact with young minds through the medium of Officers IAS Academy. And in fact, Israel happens to be my batchmate, and Rangarajan is my close colleague. So it's a proud honor and privilege, and after a long time, getting to interact also is a good thing.
So, Meenakshi, if I may start by asking, you know, everyone, waits for the cadre allotment after the results come, right? And it's even more stressful at times than even waiting for the results, right? During our days, especially when there was a roster system in place. So what was your first reaction when you got to know that you have been allotted the Assam Meghalaya cadre?
In fact, when you start preparing for this exam, you have to have an open mind to right. You have to have this basic thing in your blood, in your soul, that I'm going to serve my nation. Right. I could be allotted any part of my country, and every inch of India is my nation.
Right.
So if you have this premise, you start with this premise, then it doesn't matter which state you're allotted.
Right.
So I had this, and I should also tell you, like I was also, I had attempted the Group 1 services, the right. NPC Group 1 services.
Right.
So same time, I had the results for the 2001 exam had also come, although a bit delayed. I right. got selected in the Group 1 services Tamil Nadu Administrative Services as right. well as in the Indian Administrative Service.
Right.
So, and I got to know that Assam was my cadre. And right. As you know, all the relatives, they say that you should stay in your home state. And right. Tamil Nadu Administrative Service is as good as IAS, because here there's a certainty, 8 to 10 years you get to be nominated into the IAS.
Right.
So it makes no difference, you remain here. That was the strong pressure that I had felt from my near and dear ones.
Right.
And but my parents gave me the freedom. I should thank them. I should thank God Almighty for this opportunity to serve the nation from Assam. And I opted for Assam because the canvas is wide in IAS. And you get to serve in a variety of ways, which the state administrative services also enables you, but at a later stage.
Right.
And also, you get a national panorama, which you don't get in the state services. So
right.
For me, Tamil Nadu was not the geographical boundary of my homeland. For
right.
me, India is the geographical boundary of my homeland.
Wonderful.
So that way, Assam is for me as much a home as it would as would have been Jammu and Kashmir or Gujarat.
Wonderful, wonderful. That's really nice to hear. Yes, and what was your because I've also gone through it myself, having been to Assam for the first time, because most of us would have gone to Assam only after we got posted in that cadre. So what was your feeling like, how did you find, lot of myths, prejudices or lot of notions about people from the Northeast is instilled in the minds of people from the mainland part of the country. So what was your experience like, and how welcoming Assam was?
Once I got to know, I got selected into the Indian Administrative Service, I felt immense joy, because it was my life's ambition, and
right.
And I had sacrificed years, and my family had sacrificed a lot to see me through, and I owe it to God Almighty. And it's my mother and father's sacrifice. But when I got to know that I had got Assam, I tried to do some research. Then I got one number of an officer from Tamil Nadu, hailing from Tamil Nadu, serving in Assam. I
right.
contacted him
right.
over phone from a native village, Suttamalli in Tirunelveli. That was where I got to know. I got Assam cadre.
Okay.
Then my contact officer, who happened to be from the 2001 batch,
right.
he told me so many things about Assam. And right. then I did, of course, we have the god called Google,
right.
who wants you to know many things, actually.
Right. Right.
The Google now is much different from what it was earlier, of course.
Right.
And
right.
The net connection and other things also help you to know certain things.
Right.
And thereafter, and as I was mentally prepared, and I had no issues where I was being allotted,
right.
so I took it as a natural thing, actually.
Understood. Understood.
And during Bharat Darshan,
right.
during our, after the foundational course training,
right.
that was my first visit to Assam. When I entered the Northeast, it was. I went in for something like a green shot
right.
when I entered from New Jalpaiguri by train.
Right.
First visit was during the Bharat Darshan, and second visit was after I completed my phase one and came to Northeast for district training, Assam
right.
for district training.
Right.
So I entered through Kokrajhar. I never knew that Kokrajhar would happen to be my training district.
Right.
And when the train entered and passed through, everywhere was green, green and all green. So
right.
I was a kind of a green shop.
Right.
So this
right.
was the second shop, I should say. When I first went to Delhi from Chennai,
right.
We are all Indians, but still, first time I had ventured so far from where I had grown up for long years.
Right.
So I was in for kind of a cultural shock when I went to Delhi.
Right.
Though it's an urban climate and environment, many things were different from Chennai, and
right.
Chennai was more kind of a conservative society. Delhi is more an outgoing society.
Right.
That was one kind of thing. Similarly, I went in for a green shock when I came to Northeast.
Right.
It was a pleasant shock indeed. And why I said Northeast and particularly Assam is a blessing. Assam, in fact, I came with an open mind. I had no ifs and buts. And whatever it is, whatever God has offered me, and I will take it. Wholesome manner. And
right.
when I came here, I had, since I hailed from Tamil Nadu, I knew the political culture and environment in Tamil Nadu.
Right.
And how it impinges on the administrative setup. And
right.
here in Assam, it was quite a welcome change. In fact, officers have full scope for serving.
Right.
And in the first few months, you establish your yourself.
Credibility.
And,
yeah.
and your credibility and what you are. And then that speaks about you, and that takes care of you, in fact. And Assam, the welcome thing was, the politicians are well understanding. They give you your space. They know you. They know you better than what you think you know about yourself.
Right.
This is true for any part of the country, but
right.
more so in Assam. And here there is a space for neutral officers. So
right.
you need not be you are not bracketed into some ism or that. And this is an advantage which you will have when you go to a state which is other than your native state. Because in your native state, your identity, in India, caste is a major thing. Caste,
right.
apart from caste, many other things come into play.
Right.
So these identities kind of box you into a corner, and it's sometimes it becomes difficult in the home state to
right.
come out and reach out. Whereas
right.
you don't have any of those pressures in a state which is other than your native state. So these are the advantages, and I came to Assam, and I up till now, I tell you honestly from the heart, I'm enjoying my, and in fact, I would love to continue to serve in Assam. That's
Absolutely.
Why I came for going to Delhi on central deputation. I had
right.
quite a few opportunities to go on central deputation.
Right.
But I just love Assam.
Wonderful, wonderful.